students, welcome to the class on editorial decode. And in this class, I will be decoding Kabul's season of uncertainty written by Rakesh Sood. Now, from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus, this is important for political science optional students. Now, what is this editorial about? This editorial is about why United States of America till date has not been able to tame Taliban. This editorial is also about the role that the Pakistan is playing in taming Taliban and in engendering peace in Afghanistan. This editorial is also about why Taliban is so much against United States of America. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to dig a bit in the history of the relationship between United States of America and Taliban, and we must also try to understand and decipher the relationship with Russia. Now, when it comes to the ideology of Taliban, they are actually against United States of America because the approach, the ideology that United States of America has adopted since its birth, it has been the policy of secularism. Now, this is something that is antithetical to the ideology of Islam. Now, Islam do not believe entirely in secularism. It believes in putting forward, it believes in carrying forward the vision of Islam. Though this is something that is not explicitly mentioned in Quran, but this is a kind of a message that is given by the forces who use Islam for propagating their own benefits. Now, it is also important to understand what is the difference between Taliban and Mujahideen, and how in the past the Muslim groups had helped the United States of America to fight against Russia. Now, the war that took place, that is between Russia and Afghanistan in 1979, it was a war between the Islamic forces and between the atheist forces. Now, what is meant by atheism? Atheism means an ideology of religion in which you do not believe in God. Now, the Russia, they follow the policy of communism. Now, in communism, there is no relevancy of God. Now, when it comes to Islam, they really believe in the concept of Islam. Now, Russia was trying to set up communist regime in the Muslim world, and it was trying to stop the influence of the Western forces. So, in the fight between Russia and Afghanistan, the entire support was provided by United States of America. Now, it was United States of America's fight between capitalism and communism. Now, the fighters that had fought against Russia, they're generally called as Mujahideens. Now, this concept of Mujahideen is a holistic concept. Now, the Mujahideens, they wanted to protect their own religion. Now, after the breakup of USSR, the Mujahideen setup was established in Afghanistan. But that setup had proved to be quite corrupt. It had proved to be quite inefficient. And after that, Taliban had taken over from the Mujahideens in 1996. After 1996, the forces, the terrorist outfits like Al-Qaeda and Taliban, they had begun to exhibit a lot of hatredness against United States of America. Now, why they had begun to hate America? They had begun to hate America because Taliban is anti-Jews. Taliban and Muslim world had always wanted the justice to be done to the Palestinians. So, ipso facto, they have gone against the ideology of America. They have gone against the approach of capitalism. They had entrenched themselves as an adversary to Israel and as an adversary to Jews. And out of the hatredness of Mr. Osama bin Laden, they ended up attacking America. Now America is trying to establish peace in Afghanistan, but the peace is not coming. Now why the peace is not coming? The peace is not coming because of the incapability of the strategy that the United States of America is following. What broad strategy it is trying to follow now, after fighting war for about 15 years, for about 1.5 decades, it has realized that it must reach a kind of compromise with Afghanistan, and it is using Pakistan as a mediator without realizing that Pakistan itself is a victim of terrorism, of Taliban terrorism. Plus, there are differences that are existing between Pakistan and Afghanistan with respect to the boundary. That is, the Durand line has yet not been decided between Afghanistan and Pakistan. So both the countries have not been able to bring Taliban onto the table. And now and then, Taliban has been striking with impunity. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video class or entire civil services preparation. In order to avail the information of the class that we're offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainyis.com. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.